While we were looking at some bizarre videos, somebody suggested that we look up a person by the name of Burger Andy. And they suggested a video called Burger Andy Gets Left Behind. And so we watched this video, and it was a video of an attempted IRL streamer, a wannabe, if you will, IRL streamer, who tried to, like, be friends with Ice Poseidon and his crew, I guess. And even they made fun of him. Even Ice Poseidon was above this guy, apparently. We watched the Burger Andy Gets Left Behind video, and it was pretty funny. And after that, we decided to look into more from Burger Andy, aka Burger Planet. And what we found was truly shocking. We're going to be watching mostly one stream today. First, I'm going to be showing you a little bit of extra stuff from him, some compilations of moments, but mainly we're going to be soaking in this one stream from Burger Andy, and I think it's going to be really fun. It's a stream in which he tries to essentially pick up a girl in a diner who has some kind of developmental issue or something. It's pretty bad. It's not good. It's not a very good moment in history. I'm going to be getting into it here. So this is Burger Andy. And, yeah, this is Patricia. Take in Patricia right here. We're going to get to know her very well. But the first video that we need to watch, well, first of all, I mean, I don't mean to be rude, but, you know, this is Andy. This is what he looks like. And the first video we're going to watch here has to be Burger Andy Gets Left Behind. This is truly a classic. This is a stream where, once again, Ice Poseidon and friends, I guess, are loading themselves onto some kind of fucking bus, like a tour bus. I guess they're like the fucking Beatles of 2017. I don't know. But Burger Andy's trying to get on. He's trying to rub uglies, bump uglies with the big boys. I think that's the correct terminology. And yeah, well, let's watch.
What? Oh, you said I could get on if I ate a worm.
Oh, okay.
You guys said I could get on if I had, and they earlier you said I could get on.
Blinks. Dude.
Paul, is it cool if I come in? Come on, you said I could come on earlier.
Same people as before, we don't have enough seats.
You said I just ate a worm and shit. Right. Dude, it's sketchy out here. I don't have to walk back through there.
I mean, why'd you come here?
I came here to see you guys. You said I could come with you.
And there he is. There he is. Just a sec. Hang on, no, that's the wrong one. Those are both good choices, but yeah, so I guess he ate some kind of fucking worm or something. I guess maybe Ice Poseidon was like the schoolyard bully. He was like, why don't you eat this worm and then you could be friends with us? And then they just like, oh, you ate a worm, loser. I like the part where the guy is like, well, why'd you come then? This is truly, man, this is gonna get old quick. This is gonna get old quick.
This is like hanging out with frat dudes.
Whatever.
It's cool.
It's cool.
See, these are the frat guys of the internet, guys. The Jake Pauls of live streaming.
The Jake Pauls of live streaming. Why don't we watch some Germa after this? Yeah, so that's Burger Andy getting left behind. Hang on.
What?
What? YTF is this guy shaped like a thumb? The reflection of the door has to be one of the funniest unintentional things I've ever seen in a live stream. Apparently this was like an Oni Plays meme. When this happens, something about Black Baby, I don't know, I don't watch Oni Plays, but I've heard about that. I have heard about this. Yeah, so this is basically a wannabe IRL streamer, and at first, when somebody, you can see that has 2.4 million views. At first, when Beruf on our server suggested that we watch that, That 40-second clip is apparently all he knew about Burger Andy. And we went on a fucking six-hour tour. A six-hour tour. And big part of that six-hour fucking journey was the story of Patricia. Now, I don't know if we're going to get into that just yet, but first, maybe we should watch Burger Andy Fails compilation. Guys, people are still using the word epic fail. People are using the terms epic fail in 2020 still. I don't know how I feel about this. It's fine, actually. I do know how I feel about it. It's not very good. Stop saying the word fail.
Hey, do you mind if I have a slice of pizza? Okay, I'm just gonna have a piece. Thanks, dude.
Did he really? Oh, fuck off. Oh, God.
Score.
So, yes, this man who looks like Kay's son, an Americanized hybrid between Kay's son and Bubbles from the Trailer Park Boys, really do be like that. He just stole pizza from a homeless man. Now, if it makes it any better, if it's any consolation, Burger Andy himself is also homeless. He lives in his van. And from what we have learned, and there's very scant info about the life of Burger Andy. We've tried to find out more. But from what we've learned, Burger Andy left his wife and kids in Indiana so that he could go on a tour of live streaming adventures. IRL live streaming with Ice Poseidon, his Oni-chan or Senpai or whatever term fits. But so now he's living in his van. And so when he steals pizza from a homeless man, I mean, really, that's just the dog-eat-dog world of life, honestly.
Get out of here. Persiadina.
Have you ever been there?
You should go.
I'd love to check it out.
Check it out.
Oh, God.
Wait,
I pooped 4 times today. First day was kind of solid, then it was like, I knew my bowels were still like, felt like something still going on there. It's like, I feel this.
Oh, God damn it.
Oh, fuck. Somebody's car.
Bruh.
Let me go check it. See, this is the car I hit the bumper of. There's like green paint all over the side of the car. Obviously, I didn't do that. I didn't even hit back here. It's all scuffed up and has like other paint and like primer and shit on it. Here's where I tapped it. There's no damage.
Nah, dude, it's fine. There's already damage on the car. It's fine that I hit him. It's okay.
I could get on if I had
a
worm.
Oh, good. We get to see it again.
You guys said I could get on if I had... And they earlier...
Guys!
Said
I could get on. Dude.
Paul, is it cool if I come in? Come on, you said I could come on earlier.
Same people as before. We don't have enough seats.
You said I... And I just ate a worm and shit. Dude, it's sketchy out here.
Dude!
I have to walk back through there.
I mean, why'd you come here?
I came here to see you guys. You said I could come with you.
Dude, it's sketchy out here. You never know what kind of people you'll find in this part of in this neck of the woods. Someone in chat asks how old this guy is, and I guessed that he was probably in his late 20s, but looks older. He looks like he's in his like early 40s or late 30s. Other people guessed by his appearance that he probably is that age, but I was like, no, he probably is just very unhealthy and looks much older than he actually is. You know, like me.
No, no. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Content. Lick it off.
Oh, God.
Guys, okay, we can't watch this. We can't watch this. This is going to spoil Patricia for us. We're not watching Patricia.
See a poll of what the video... Do I like mentally challenged girls? Yeah.
That's just such a good quote. That, and as Bear said, that quote will be important later. You might already have some guesses as to why I'm skipping the Patricia part, other than we're going to see that later. But yeah. Oh, it's this part. Great.
Who doesn't? Can you guys believe this? So my freaking, get this, my ex-girlfriend, she mailed me a picture of my kids the other day, trying to make me feel bad. Can you believe this? I'm not moving back to Indiana. I don't care how cute my children are. Quit trying to get.
So yeah, he just has. I remember seeing this on a randomly. We clicked on the stream where this happened, and he was just like, "Hey guys, get a load of this!" And he just pans down, and there's this fucking blurry ass PNG of his kids. It's just, it was great. It was great. I'm glad that they put that in here.
Quit trying to get.
Is it all right if I say, just try to say you're cool and everything? I'm just trying to be respectful and stuff. I didn't mean to.
Oh, by the way, this is an important character in the mythos. This right here, this is Asian Andy, ladies and gentlemen. Oh God, is my fucking stream? Oh, that's why everything sucks. This is Asian Andy. This is one of many other Andes. This is on the Council of Andes. He sits second from the left. Get used to Asian Andy. We might look at him later at some point, too. Apparently, from what we know, he's also a bit of a scumbag.
Wow, that would be crazy. Those people drink a lot when it gets started.
Hey, thank you for the super chat. They said, tell this fat fuck to eat healthy, work out, and to stop being a bitch. Okay, well, I'll be a little nicer than that, but,
you already said it.
Yeah, like, what do you mean?
Walk out the door, you see someone that you know, and they ask you how you are, and you just have to say that you're
okay,
fine.
Okay, these memes are already dead. I have to put new memes on by the start of the next stream.
You're like, I'll be more nice than that, but tell this fucking retard he's a fat piece of shit.
I read the super chats, well, bro. I read the super chats.
Dude, I just read the super chats. So, this is another big thing that you'll start to, if you don't know anything about IRL streamers, that's something big that you'll start to notice is that the super chat thing, the Twitch donation announcement thing, playing on a loudspeaker so everybody can hear it. That's a big meme, I guess, and people will, as you might expect, people will exploit the hell out of that shit. So we're gonna see some of that later with Patricia.
Fuck these guys. Knock these fucking fools out.
Knock these fools out. I'll harm you. I don't even know what that clip was, but it was pretty good.
Look at this.
You couldn't even script anything better than that.
Somebody sent me this. Open it up. Mm-hmm. There will be a bombing in New York City on September 23rd, followed by flooding. Fair warning, the horror of Babylon.
All right, well, that one sure escalated quickly. What the fuck happened there? Apparently someone did get in trouble because they made a fucking super chat bomb threat, and the guy who was doing the stream had a backpack on, so that was not good.
Wrote this on 8/29/2017. Okay. So I need to call.
That's what you get.
I need to call.
That's what you get.
No,
I need to get the FBI over to my stream tomorrow. And I need to figure
Wait, so did Burger Randy do that? Is that him who did this? Oh my god.
I don't know, Paul. Maybe it's just like... Hopefully that was a joke, but is that...
You know, you can't joke about terrorism today's day.
You can't joke about terrorism. You can't.
The FBI...
I won't allow it!
Pissing me off.
Can't come into Ice Poseidon's house and piss on hospitality. I won't allow it!
Apologize, we're gonna start the show later. Sometimes you gotta psychologically back you.
Okay, so here's Mr. T. I don't know what's going on in this one.
Yeah. Somebody need to go to the bathroom intellectually. Show's on hold.
Look at he head!
If you find a mirror, you'll know why I stopped the show. Everyone, we're gonna start again a little longer, a little later. You know, because he over here interviewing people in the middle of the show. You know, like he with me and he ain't with me. I want you to kill that.
He's fucking Burger Andy holding up an entire, like, street performance with his stupid bullshit.
Oh, it ain't fucked up. That's the way I like to do that.
Fucked up, man.
Don't do drugs, guys.
That's fucked up, y'all.
Don't do drugs, guys, says the guy who was allegedly caught using crack cocaine.
Fuck. That is a Sears cargo thing.
Why is he a Yakuza character? I don't know, dude.
Somebody in this is... Let's see what's in it, right? Should we see what's in this?
Well, you clearly already have your heart set on this one.
What do you guys think's in this thing? This is like a
Hopefully we might find the focus inside.
What do you guys think? What is in this? It looks kind of old. Looks kind of dirty. What's in it, guys?
Looks kind of old. Looks kind of dirty. Oh, wait, that's me.
Oh, shit. There's a person in it. Oh, fuck. Sorry, dude.
I need to have the Zelda treasure chest sound. That would have been great.
I don't want to get all sentimental.
Who the fuck is this girl? Who the fuck is sitting with him?
I barely know you. I've met you twice.
You're awesome. The times that we spent.
I've hung out with you twice. Slow the fuck down.
The time that we've
put the brakes on your emotions.
Whoa, I have not.
I'm trying to let a girl fall in love with me too quickly.
I'm not saying.
So apparently she's like his simp or something. Apparently Burger Andy has simps. How about that one?
Hello, can you just stop yelling, please?
No, that's Burger Planet.
Burger Planet.
This is my child.
Burger Planet.
Whoa. Don't talk to me or my son ever again.
Yeah. Are you that famous?
Huh? Me?
Yes, I am super famous. You know why?
Oh, damn, it's the singer from Jane's Addiction.
Hold on.
If you were real famous, you'd give me a 20 spot.
I mean, if you were real famous, you'd probably give me a Tesla, honestly.
What the fuck?
Well, you're saying I'm not famous enough.
I'm not famous enough, I'm sorry. It's like, yeah, dude, you live in a van. Alright, so it's time to get into, not the Thai ladyboy hunter, not that. We're not going to get into that. But what we are going to get into, it's time to look at his actual... He calls himself... Well, people call him... I don't know if he calls himself this, but he calls himself Burger... He's known as Burger Andy. But his actual name is Burger Planet. And if we look at Burger Planet here on YouTube... I don't think he is banned on Twitch, because he's still going. He's still living out of his van, still streaming recently. So we watched... Let me go to his channel, actually. We don't need to watch the trailer, but we watched recently a stream that he had uploaded from... What was it? It was like April or something. Fuck this. Sort by most popular... was it around here? I don't know. Here's Patricia. We're gonna get to Patricia shortly. But there was a really good stream. I can't find it. Hang on. Family Barbecue. Court-ordered time with my kids. Huh. The video is dark comedic satire. I'm only the kid's uncle. I don't like that. So did he remove the one stream? To family roasted? It was like... Yeah, Father's Day picnic. Family roasted me. And this is a 6-hour stream. We're not going to be watching all of this. Not like the Patricia one. But we are going to be skimming through a little bit of this. Because this is a 6-hour stream. Where he's at some kind of... picnic with his family, I guess. It's something about his brother. I don't know what happened, but he's with his family, and,
Okay.
The part that we skipped to, he was out here, and he's like, so all the rest of the family is in this little pavilion over here, and he's out ostracized from everybody with the kids.
You did? What? And she said no. Then we went to the wedding and was like, oh, she does it.
And, okay, now we're into that area of things. I don't know if I really want to show the children necessarily, but suffice it to say, during the segment here where he's like hanging with the kids, it's a very awkward segment where one of the children, he keeps, Burger Andy keeps asking the kid for money. And he keeps saying that it's his brother's kids, but, I mean, he claims that he's also the parent sometimes. I don't know, it's weird. I know he does have kids, and they look a lot like those kids, so I'm not sure. But, yeah, the kids just start fucking roasting him about how he lives in a van, and how, like, my daddy's right about you, you're a loser, and all this stuff. And, yeah, Burger Andy's really one of those people who... I guess the only thing that he can do to remain in some way paying his bills, whatever those might be, I guess gas bills, is by, like, being very pathetic. He's not quite at Nikocado levels yet. He isn't shitting himself for views quite yet, but he's close. He is close. So during this family meal, there's this long segment where... he's here, and he's sitting with his relatives, and I guess this is, like, his extended family. And they're all, like, eating, they're all talking with each other, conversing, asking how the wife and kids are and whatnot. And over here is Burger Andy with his fucking phone and his live stream, just like, oh yeah, this is good content. My fucking 10 Twitch followers really want to see Aunt Mildred over here drinking a Coke. Yeah, that's bang on Twitch content right there. And it's just such a chilling picture when we see him just here. His only company is his Twitch people. And all the rest of the family is like, what's going on with him? Why is he fucking like this? Why isn't he just talking with the family? Why does he have to put us on this camera? Most of these people probably don't understand that their privacy is being fucking invaded right now, which is also kind of a concern. And it's a concern with a lot of IRL streaming, but yeah. Someone asks when I will live stream the Atop the Fourth Wall movie. Oh, ho, 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 you sweet summer child. Oh, I see you're new. Oh, what great content, you know? I know when I come to a Twitch stream, what I expect to see is a dude fucking hanging with his elderly family. Yeah. Yeah, the most exciting thing about this entire picture right now is this guy's bald spot. So, yeah, this goes on for several hours, and he chills with the kids. And then there's this long segment of time where he's, like, ranting about how much he hates his family, and he's parked in a graveyard. He's just in a graveyard, and I don't know if we're going to get to hear it, but at one part he's like, so here I am at the graveyard, visiting my career, and he's just screaming about his fucking family and making weird noises. And in this frame, more than ever, it becomes clear that this guy looks like a weird parallel universe version of Clint LGR, which I don't make that comparison happily, but I'm not wrong either.
70 bajillion? Your brother's wife is hot. He really does have it all. I don't know. She seems like a stress, man. She's a nice girl, but
Seems kind of a little high maintenance for my taste.
Someone in chat says the framing is cinematic, and I'm inclined to agree with you. That is the feeling that I had when I first saw this. Was like, this is unintentional art. This is like a photographer's wet dream. The focus of the fucking video is this graveyard, and he's just off to the corner, and it's just perfect. This is like an art film shot. But he just doesn't even know how good this shot is.
Takes her a long time to get ready. All that. And she, like, moved into his house.
3505 in the video? Okay. Let me see. Perfect. Play the video.
Wait! I'm gonna go with you! I wanna come with you!
A 90-year-old. Yeah. Right over here. All right, later, Cool Cat.
It's him. It's Cool Cat. There he is. Yeah, I remember this part. In this part of the video, he desperately tries to flee this family gathering by any means necessary. By like, wait, I want to go with you. Let me in. To this guy who's in his car, who is going to some party for a 90-year-old or something. Which, to be fair, it seems like this picnic already is. But also, to be fair, obviously this guy doesn't want to be around him. But yeah, so Burger Andy's just stranded at the fucking picnic once again. But yeah, so, you know, that's that stream. And that's just one of many classic Burger Andy situations. And we're going to take a look now at the main course, the most perfect stream of the hour, Patricia and Burger Planet. Now, this opening frame here really sets the tone for the whole entire video, to be honest. Burger Andy, he's here at a place called, I believe it's Tommy's Diner in Los Angeles. And to set the plot for this stream. Basically, he is here and he is homeless, and he is with two other homeless brothers who throughout most of the stream are attempting to catch some fucking Z's in the booth at the Tommy's Diner. But Burger Planet is energized, as we can clearly see. Burger Planet is fully energized, filled with gusto and bravado. And he is about to he's not looking for sleep, he's looking for love. So that's what's happening in this stream, and we're going to jump ahead a little bit here. As you can see, we got the...
So it'll just be something.
We got Wooly over here.
Yeah,
so this is Wooly and Pat. This is alternate universe Wooly and Pat. It's a black guy with dreadlocks and a short, fat ginger. It's great. I'm going to start yelling about the stadium after this.
Do a different one. Okay. Yeah, it's good, too, to like weed out like the people that are just asleep and stuff and non-active.
So, yeah, he and his homeboy are sitting here eating some fries. It's strange that Burger Andy would eat his namesake like that, cannibalize his people. I guess he leaves the diner for a little bit. I didn't really see this part, but
this guy.
I don't know why he's crying now.
Oh my god. Oh my god. This guy. Now I have to look like this, freak.
Insane, thank you.
Oh, I guess that was acting. Oh man, Onision has some fucking competition now. You know, he might be able to knock over his chair, but this guy's got the crying glasses scene. I believe that was a selection from 13 Reasons Why. Very powerful. Very powerful.
You look tired. Well, I don't.
I'm pretty sure this is the like burger guy from 13 Reasons Why, by the way.
Prob, you don't have a picture of yourself. So. Whatever. Let's not talk about what you look like. Stop the gay crying. Not funny. Oh,
Straight people cry too, Mushroom. Straight people cry
too. Yeah, that's rude. You can't say things like that on the internet. So again, I didn't know that happened, but we're gonna jump ahead here. And I think this is about where it starts popping off. Is this where it starts happening? Where does it start happening? Okay, the police are here. I don't know. I'm still finding things in the stream. There are still things that I didn't know happened in this fucking amazing stream. Why are the police here?
Play though, because they got those old ass. They got those old ass cars from the 90s. This would take her. She's beautiful. They said that girl's beautiful.
Once again, another great framing for this shot. Just like, focus on the cop car in the background. This is like a scene from Airplane. This is like a background like comedy skit that's happening that is just like a visual gag. It's beautiful. So the cops are here. I guess there must just be a lot of fucking trouble at the Tommy's Diner, which makes a lot of sense if you consider all of the events that are about to occur in this stream. But soon our boy is going to be laying eyes on the love of his life. And where is she? Where is the? There she is. There she is. Okay, we're gonna catch this in full. We're gonna go to 47 minutes, and we're just gonna see how the interaction with Patricia starts. Cause I don't even remember.
You're still fucking wasting the cop's time. Little to no fucking. He's got a whole goddamn bandage. They didn't even go to the bathroom and wash. They could have just washed that shit off.
They're saying when the Patricia segment starts, but again, we're watching from a little before that, so we can see her walk in and we can, you know, really get the juices flowing, as it were.
Oh my god! Yo, she got some friends. Yo, what up, girl? My name's Josh.
So once again, apparently his name's not even fucking Andy. I don't know why people call him Burger Andy. But there's that.
You got some friends that like a white chubby boy with a red beard? But I got some money. I mean, not that much, but I got like 20 bucks.
What is he like, FaceTiming with a girl?
Spend it wisely.
We've been up mobbing through the city.
Mob. There she is! It's her! The saga begins!
Oh shit, what are you doing?
Hey, oh, he's locked eyes with the female and now it's time. It is time for him to fucking pounce. The moment he sees her, it's like, oh shit, what are you doing? Fucking, it's just like, all of a sudden, you're drawn into a random encounter with Burger Andy.
Where'd you come from? Where are you at? Hey, I thought I saw you over there. What's up? I'm Josh.
Hi.
What's your name?
Patricia.
Patricia?
Yep.
Come and sit on me. You want a milkshake?
Huh?
I was going to get a milkshake. Do you want one?
I don't have money.
Okay, you want a milkshake. You like chocolate or strawberry?
Strawberry.
Strawberry? Okay, let's go get one.
What if she wanted vanilla?
I don't have money.
I'm going to buy it for you.
Maybe?
So we're going to start to notice pretty quickly in this stream that our boy is just a little bit of a fucking weirdo. This girl clearly, on one hand, she can barely speak English, so she maybe doesn't understand a lot of the things that he's about to say to her. She won't understand a lot of the... Okay, we don't need the background. It's a little too loud. We're still working on the settings, but she's not going to understand a lot of the stuff that he's going to be saying to her in the oncoming parts. And the other part is clearly something's wrong. She's developmentally something. I don't know what exactly, but something's not right in the state of Thailand or wherever she's from. I'm not sure, but I think it's the Philippines, actually. The point is, coupled with the fact that he previously said, oh, yeah, dude, I love mentally challenged girls. This is Burger Andy. Strap the fuck in for the stream.
Why not? You're a nice girl. Can I talk to you? Can I buy you a milkshake?
What's that? YouTube?
I'm on YouTube, yeah. Why are you looking all happy? Let's get strawberry. It's all fun and games. I'm gonna get chocolate. You can have strawberry if you
it's
want.
It's all fun and games.
Okay. Where are you from?
Andy.
You're from Los Angeles?
What's your name? Who's your daddy? Is he? Does he live in a van like me?
Yeah.
Okay. I look so tall next to you. You're so little. Can I put my arm around it? You're so pretty. Nice.
How old are you?
Oh shit, I'm old. How old do you think I am?
I don't know.
Yes.
Gotta raise that sangi a little bit.
Can I get a chocolate milkshake and a strawberry milkshake? Let's get the small ones, yeah.
Now not to give too much away here, but chocolate milkshake and a strawberry milkshake is actually very symbolic for things later on in the video. Well, I'm just gonna leave it at that.
Huh? 'Cause they told you I'm 35? what? Six so what? Okay. Here, I have to like... Oh my gosh. Well, that's no fair. They told you the answer.
Aye.
How old are you?
Yeah.
26. Higher or lower?
Lower.
24. 23.
And again, higher.
Huh? 18. 19.
25.
25?
Yeah. Apparently she's 25.
Ah, so close.
Ah, so close after 15 tries or whatever.
Go tonight. You just wake up?
Yeah.
Man, you wake up early. You wanna go walk somewhere?
You wanna go walk somewhere?
Oh, yeah.
What's up?
What happened with all that stuff?
I don't know.
You guys are still working that out?
So.
Why don't you go to the bathroom and wash your blood off your
hands? Why is there blood on his hands? Why is there blood in... Well, what's going on? Why is there blood in this situation?
I would wash it all off.
There's just so many questions, Chad, and I still don't have most of the answers.
Hold on. I don't want my card to be on the thing.
Okay. You have money?
Yeah, I just paid for it with my money.
Yeah, girl, I just paid for it with my money. I have a whole $10. You know, this is a very beautiful romance story, really. She was a Vegas girl, he was macho man Andy Savage. It's truly a classic Harlequin romance.
It's gonna be really big. Are you that hungry? Can you eat a triple? Well, take a triple then. Have a good day, boss man. Thank God you didn't have to go out there and kick some ass. Motherfuckers would have to recognize the power.
Okay, we're gonna jump ahead a little. Okay, actually, never mind. It's time for him to try to explain to her a little bit. Because she's repeatedly kind of interested by what the fuck he's doing with the phone and the chat and the people. And soon there's gonna be super chat messages, and that's gonna be a whole fucking thing. So she's looking at the phone here.
Motherfuckers would have to recognize the power.
Respect my authority.
What's your name?
Patricia.
Patricia?
Patricia.
Patricia? So how do you say that? With a P?
Oh, yeah, dude. It's definitely Patricia. Good. You're great.
Patricia or Patricia?
It's the kind of guy who requires subtitles on someone on TV who's got even the slightest bit of a fucking accent. This is that. This is the demographic for that.
Patricia.
Yeah.
Like Pepsi.
Yeah.
Patricia.
Patricia. Like Pepsi. Yeah. Exactly, dude. Sure.
Doesn't contain milk or butter or anything like
Why
that.
Why are you in the YouTube?
Royce. Royce is on here?
Combo or something?
Oh, that's my ex-boyfriend.
Everything on a triple?
I didn't tell you I'm gay.
Yeah, just no cheese.
Wow.
Chili's.
Oh. Hang on. Yeah, I still don't know what the gay part is. I guess that's supposed to be a joke because he continues hitting on her. So I don't know. Maybe he's trying to break the tension with a joke, I guess. It's not really a joke in any way. I mean, it's not even set up as a joke, but that's fine.
Okay, just sorry.
Really?
Yes. Is it okay?
I don't think so.
Oh, Patricia's not a great. I don't know about sus on Patricia. I don't know.
Where to go? 10:05.
Yes, my ex-boyfriend Royce is watching. Let's go eat our milkshakes. Let's just don't worry. I'm bisexual, so that's fine. I do women too.
I'm bisexual. It's fine. I do women too. It's fine, baby girl. It's fine, kitten. It's fine, princess.
Oh God. All right. You wanted the strawberry. Straw.
Thank you.
A straw for the strawberry.
Oh God.
This guy, I think he is...
By the way, straw for the strawberry is about the height of his humor in this video. Intentional humor, anyway.
He voted for Obama.
Okay.
What?
You're so funny.
Thank you. When you're this ugly, you have to be funny, you know?
Yeah.
Because I, like, look like shit. fuck. So what do you do?
Do you smoke?
Like crack or what?
Do you smoke?
Cigarettes? No.
I like how the first thing he thinks of. So again, allegedly he was caught smoking crack. I don't know how true this was. I don't know what might have happened. I haven't seen the video, but that's what I've heard. And I like that when she says, "Do you smoke?" The first thing he thinks is, "Oh yeah, you mean crack? Yeah. Oh dude, I love. I'm a vintage." Personally, I collect vintage crack, and,
yeah.
You smoke?
Yeah.
Get the fuck out of here. You're so pretty. Why do you smoke? That's gross.
I know.
Are you gonna quit?
Smoke? Smoke? Oh, you mean like, you mean like, burning a strip of cardboard and smoking it, like, that, like Stomedy, right? That's what you mean, right? That's what everybody thinks when you say smoke, right?
That's kind of a deal breaker for me. I don't like dating people that smoke. You want a boyfriend?
I guess.
You guess? Alright. Well, whatever, you know. I could just quit smoking recently. I shouldn't judge. I smoked for 10 years.
Wow.
I know. I quit, though, in August or April. I feel so much better.
You have girlfriend?
Huh?
Girlfriend?
Do the dog twin what?
You have girlfriend?
Do I have hot girls?
Yeah.
Do I like hot girls?
Mm-hmm.
I love hot girls.
I don't like this. I don't like this. I don't like this. She just asked if he had a girlfriend, and he's turning it into, oh yeah, I love hot girls. Good God.
You like hot boys? Shit. Motherfucker.
Motherfucker!
Alright, never above you, never below you, always beside you. Cheers. Is it good?
Yeah. That is my thing.
That's your
friend? Okay, so now we get to meet the third big player in this whole situation. These tiny little pixels in the background, that is her friend. And when she mentioned her friend, it set us off on a fucking evening of questions and surprising answers. You will not believe where this stream goes. I'm going to be real with you. I'm going to be real with you. You have no idea what's going on with this man. But let's continue.
You know that guy?
Mm-hmm.
You know that man?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Can I talk to him? Well, I'm sitting here.
Huh?
I'm just gonna sit here.
People in chat are saying it's the pimp. Oh, you think it's that simple. You think it's that simple.
No, talk to him.
Is he nice?
Yeah. He's mine.
Okay, go talk to him.
There's other people saying it's the simp, and now I'm just wishing that there was like a self-help book called From Simp to Pimp. You know, life tips and 10 easy steps or something. That'd be great.
Come. He's nice.
He's nice. Oh, wait, do we meet him already? Did I miss this part? Oh, God. Are we going to meet him?
He's very nice to me.
This is her friend. Do you want to be on the video or no? Oh, he doesn't want to be on the video. Your friend doesn't want to be on the video. Oh, no worries. All right, I'm going to go back and sit in my chair. Enjoy the milkshake. Come back and talk if you want.
Oh, boy.
You're welcome.
So he just walked Milady back to her boyfriend or whatever. At least that's probably what he thinks is going on. Again, you will not guess where this is going. But, yeah. Once we found out about the friend over there, all manner of theories started popping up. We thought it might have been her handler, like someone to make sure she, you know, gets home okay. We thought it might have been like her relative or something, because we didn't get a good look at him until later in the stream. But, all manner of theories. At one point we thought that, well, no, I can't say what we thought she might have been doing. I can't say what one of the theories was, because that would be spoilers, but... He streamed yesterday. Well, good for him. So is he crying now? Is this just him crying? So I guess the conceit of this is he bought the girl a milkshake and then had to walk her back to her bowl. Oh, that's unfortunate. And now he's sad. Now he crying.
She loves me. She loves me not.
Bitch.
If it doesn't break through and the knot stays, that means she doesn't love me.
Oh, God damn it.
Why's her pimp gotta be so fucking non-retarded? What the fuck?
Did he really just say, okay, so I guess he already is of the theory that he is the pimp. Of course, that was another big theory, was that guy was the pimp. And I guess that's just what chat said, and maybe he assumed it as well. I don't really know, but I guess even he was of the theory that guy's the pimp. But I guess he's very surprised by the non-retardedness, and that's a quote, of the pimp. But again, you won't get... You think it's just a pimp, but you will not guess what's happening with this man.
I'm gonna have to give him money now to marry her. How much it cost to buy your money pit?
Can't wait to get my entire YouTube channel and Twitch claimed because of this background music in a fucking diner. That's great.
Fucking only opportunity tonight, and I fucked it up.
Guys, he bought a milkshake for her and everything. Please answer me. This is just like the guy... He even looks like the dude who was like, I showed you my dick, please answer me. Oh, no. I'm sure he's playing up the crying a little bit for the stream, but here she is again. She comes back. Oh, bring me your higher love. That's great. That's a perfect song. I would love to buy the Patricia and Burger Planet official soundtrack. That would be great. A nice double album of greatest hits from the Tommy's Diner. You know, to commemorate this classic romance and whatnot. Here he is breaking a fucking, busting a move.
Me a higher love. Oh, yeah.
Oh wait, that's the wrong. Oops. That's that was supposed to be the Mr. Anime dance, but you know what? That one's more fitting, honestly.
Patricia.
They want to talk to you.
Okay, we're going to skip over the higher love here. Let's get over to Patricia.
Hey.
Guys, the chat wants to talk to Patricia. It's definitely them.
What are you doing after this? Do you want to go walk to, like, Griffith Park or something? Or what are you doing?
Nothing.
You're not doing anything? What is that thing?
Something.
Huh? What does it do?
Huh?
What does that little thing do?
That king.
The what?
It's king.
What does that little thingy do? Oh, it's just a necklace?
Yes.
Is he really confused about the fucking necklace? Are you kidding me?
Oh, okay. Sorry. My back hurts so bad. How's your milkshake?
Good.
You liked it?
Bane just says she looks a little, yeah. Yeah. Welcome, Bane, Fuzo, and I guess you missed the part earlier in the stream where he said, he read a chat message asking him a question. He said, do I like mentally challenged girls? Ah, hell yeah, who doesn't? So welcome to the stream.
A massage. My back is like, hurts really bad right here.
Oh, she's giving him a massage?
Oh, thank you. Can you do like the hand, like... Here, let me show you how to do it. Here's your hand. Do like this? Like.
Oh god. Oh god.
Like around the shoulders. Oh yes.
Oh yes. Oh yes. Oh. Oh, beautiful.
Oh yeah.
Oh, that's that. Oh, right there. Oh yeah. That's the good stuff. She's just staring blankly into space. She's got the fucking thousand-yard stare. Maybe it's finally occurring to her that she's rubbing Burger Andy's back. I don't know.
Oh, thank you. That feels so good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, don't hit it. Don't. No, 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 that hurts.
Right.
No, no, don't do that. It hurts. Yeah, just do the first thing. Yeah. Oh.
$40.
$40. So this was a big point of contention. We were wondering if this was a joke or what. The guy, the friend in the background is like, after you're done, tell him $40. And we started to wonder if this guy might be like holding her against her will. And without spoiling too much, Burger Andy starts to wonder the same thing too.
For what?
For my truck.
Oh my god.
Huh?
That guy makes you pay $40 for things?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know.
Well, I can't pay $40 for that. I give you a milkshake. I thought you were my friend.
I gave you a milkshake. That means you have to massage my back in a public diner. Come on. You know the rules, woman.
Huh? Oh no, you do that?
Yeah.
No, you're such a nice girl. Why you do that?
Why?
I liked you. Yeah. Oh,
so, at this point, you might be thinking, okay, well, she basically just said that, yeah, I do that, and he is my pimp. And you might be thinking, okay, well, it's an open and shut case, right? Except that, once again, please remember, this girl hardly understands English. And multiple times later in the video, she will contradict herself a minute after saying something. And she'll be like, oh, my parents are dead or something. And then she'll say something else about her parents. And it's like, there's a clear level of miscommunication here. So anything that she says is not necessarily what's happening. Or at least we think that. I don't know. Let's keep watching.
I don't know. But he like.
Jesus.
I really like the look on it. He's just like blown away, like, wow, I can't believe it.
So,
you know, Burger Andy's gonna take us someplace even higher, honestly. If he's got two buddies here, if he needs to, he can fucking break his way out of this Tommy's Diner that's apparently surrounded by police. If he needs to, he can fucking shank a bitch with that milkshake straw.
Is that guy threatening me?
Huh?
Is he threatening me? What's he saying? I don't trust him.
Why?
He said I owe him $40. I didn't give him. I'm not giving him any money. I don't know him.
So I think the only reason she's over here at this point, sitting with him still, is because she needs to charge her phone. So I guess she's just over there with him. I don't think we've seen any of the hilarious fucking super chats yet, but that will happen. Yeah, he's not really very concerned at all about whether or not this girl, who's clearly very challenged mentally, is being in some way abused by this guy. He doesn't really seem to care about that. He's just like, dude, I'm not paying $40. What the fuck, bro? No way. Fuck that. Stinky.
Look at my arm. I get cut. I fell down.
Yeah.
How long you been from LA? How long you been in LA? 7 years?
Yep.
Oh, wow.
Guys, she literally just counted with fingers. It's a good thing I have the One Winged Angel music queued up.
From?
Philippines.
You're from the Philippines?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Filipino?
Yeah.
So beautiful. Why did you move to California?
I didn't know my mom.
You don't know your mom?
My mom and dad, they want.
You never met your mom and dad?
I'm with you, baby! Once again, the background, the soundtrack, the diegetic soundtrack in this film, this art piece of a fucking movie that we are watching today. This is truly one of the most Kino parts of the entire experience. However, I doubt Twitch will feel the same, so I am going to be skipping ahead a little bit.
I live with my mom and dad.
I used to live with my mom and dad. There's nothing wrong with that. That's okay. You live with them now? You still live with them now?
Huh?
You still live with them now, or in the Philippines you live with them?
Here.
You live with them here? Oh, well, that's good.
She said something earlier, and I think I did skip over it, but she does say earlier, and he is like, he confirms it at least, or he translates it, I guess, for us, and he's like, oh, your parents died. So maybe, and then she says, yeah. So again, it's a lot of layers of like, what is she even saying? What is real? What's actually happening? This is truly a David Lynch film.
These guys came by the window now.
Which guys? You mean the fucking police? You mean the police are still outside? So this girl is clearly mentally challenged and being in some way turned out, or at least he thinks so, by this friend of hers. And he's just doing nothing to tell the police about it or say anything to fucking... By the way, there's the like to dislike ratio. How about that? I think even his followers agree that this is quite a fucking stream. But yeah, he doesn't seem to really care too much about... Well, no, I shouldn't say that, because later on in the stream there are parts where he's like, dude, that guy is bad to you. You gotta lose him or whatever. But it's more for his own benefit and less for hers. So yeah, there's that. That happens too.
So what do you do for work?
Nothing.
You don't do anything for work?
Uh-uh.
How do you make money? Huh?
Nothing. Who's that guy?
Who's these guys? I don't know. They're drunk people.
Drunk?
Ay, ay, ay.
Ay, ay, ay. Can we just watch that again?
Guys, I don't know. They're drunk people.
Ay, ay, ay. You're only here?
Me? I'm just sitting here. I don't know. I'm just sitting here. What do you mean? Am I only here? I'm not only here.
No.
I go other
I'm places. Not only I here. I am here. Now.
I live in L.A., yeah.
Where is the N.A.?
Huh?
N.A. what?
Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much. $20? Thank you so much. Is that $20?
Yeah, I'm going to get that
one. Oh, my God. Holy shit.
What?
You look like a skinned chicken nugget. $2. Respect to the shop owners and burger, the homie. $10. And this is not a Nick. This is not a Nick. $20 again. Thank you, not as Nick. $20. Get away. I am... Oh, my God.
So now I think is when he starts to notice the hilarious super chats that are happening in this situation. And I think this is maybe when he turns on the ability for us to hear them in the restaurant. And again, just an endless source of wonderment when this does happen.
Thank you so much. I don't appreciate your comment, but I like your money. Oh, it's $3.
Why are you in the YouTube?
Cause that's how I make money. If the people give money on this, it does like a thing and I make money. See if they give like $3 here. I'll show you how it works. It's better than a lot of jobs, you know? Oh. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've had a lot of shitty jobs.
Yeah, too. Sitting here for 3 hours in a fucking diner with a bunch of drunk homeless people. Yeah. It's definitely better than other jobs, truly, truly. This guy could be working in an office right now with his wife and kids in Indiana, but it's a good thing he decided to nope the fuck out of that and live the high life with Patricia.
Have you ever been to the Grand Canyon?
Huh?
Have you ever been to Colorado?
No.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Yeah. Me and you going there, huh?
I don't think your friend would like that. He said I owe him money.
Huh?
I don't think your friend would like that. He says I owe him money. Will your friend let me go with you?
Huh?
Yeah. I mean, we could, maybe.
Yeah.
I love this. When a girl offers, even this girl, even in this situation, she's like, oh, we could go to the Grand Canyon. Clearly, she's... Like, she doesn't understand the implications of saying a thing like that, but she's like, oh, we could go to the Grand Canyon, and he's just like, his first thought is, oh, I don't know, I'm sure your friend wouldn't let me. Can I get do I need to get a permission slip from your friend?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, my back hurts.
Oh, God.
You want to go there with me?
Mm-hmm.
Can I kiss you?
And she just pulls away. She.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, she's telling him to kiss him. She's telling him to kiss her on the cheek. Even in this situation, she knows. Don't let this guy kiss you on the lips. Oh God.
Oh, my back hurts so bad. Oh, I hurt it so bad.
No.
God damn it. I messed up the video. Oh shit. Walk in the rain. Oh God. What does this feel like? I'm all alone.
And yes, someone in chat asks a very crucial and important question. Why would he post this? He did indeed post this. This is him. This is his posting. This is his channel. This is a video he chose to upload to YouTube. So I guess this is a highlight for him.
I said sometimes I feel like I'm all alone. It's so tough. I think it's a song too.
Yeah, it's weird that someone at the fucking Tommy's Diner, I guess maybe they were having a laugh with him. They saw him sitting over here trying to fucking woo this girl. And they were just like, hey, Jim, put on Emotion 94.5 hosted by Fernando Martinez. Let's play fucking all day power ballads here in the Tommy's Diner. That's great.
You have baseball?
Do I have a girlfriend?
Baseball.
A bake? Do I mean?
Oh my god, a bake. Yeah, she's asking you if you bake, you fucking degenerate. Holy shit.
Yeah, I do have Facebook, but I already have it filled. You only use Facebook? You have Instagram?
Yeah.
You want to do Instagram?
Mm-hmm.
You don't do any juicy bikini shots over on Instagram that I can creep on? Damn, girl. Now, I'm pretty sure she didn't ask for him to do this.
Patricia. Oh, the money.
Help, I am being kidnapped by the guy at the other table.
And so begins the super chats. A strong contender for my favorite part of the stream. especially his and her reaction to pretty much all of them.
Thank you for the $3.
Thank you for the $3.
Wow.
They usually just say bad things, but then that gives me money. So I don't really know what to do about it. I just have to take the money and appreciate it. Beak, Beak, you better shut the fuck up. I will block you.
Yeah, you can only verbally assault me and, well, verbally assault. You can only point out the scummy things that I'm doing and make a laugh out of it. Yeah, if you give me money first, thank you.
Can we dance?
Huh?
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Let's dance.
Oh my god.
I don't have a gun.
Can I show you one move?
Yes.
Okay. Here, put your phone down so charge it. It'll be okay.
You know, with music like this playing, maybe it makes sense. Ma'am, this is the Wendy's. Sir, please. Yeah, so again, should they just start fucking dancing in the middle of this diner? Imagine you're there eating your fucking, like, your eggs and bacon or whatever in the morning. You're just vibing. You're just eating your fucking eggs. You've just been through a bunch of Waffle House brawls all over the evening. You've been on a fucking late night bender. And you get to watch this shit, man. Like, this is great. Imagine working there.
People said Beauty and the Beast. They called me the Beast.
You're not. We can't be sure which one they were referring to. Let's be real.
Beauty and the Beast. Next up, Dancing with the Stars. Imagine the thoughts going through those guys' mind right now.
Dancing with the what?
Her pimp is Dank One.
it's so funny that everybody's making fun of me. It's great.
You.
Who?
You.
Me.
Right?
Why they are talking me?
Once again, the people, the victims, one might say, that show up on this guy's streams seem to have very little understanding most of the time. And you haven't seen the extent of it, but from what we've seen, he often picks on people who are, like, pretty clearly, like, you know, immigrants that don't speak a lot of English, and they're kind of, you know, he's able to kind of confuse them a little bit, and they don't understand what he's doing with his fucking phone, or that they're having their fucking face blasted to thousands. And a thing about all of this, an undercurrent of this entire situation, as fun as it is to do the memes of them dancing in this fucking burger joint, This is, again, this is just some girl who shouldn't be on this stream. She shouldn't have been exposed to all this attention. And it is funny to make jokes, but it's also kind of like every time I'm left to remember that, you know, it's at the expense of someone who really shouldn't be there.
They think you're pretty. I don't know. The people in here, they're bored. You know, they have nothing to do.
I know.
Mm. Have you ever been on YouTube before?
Huh?
Have you ever been on a YouTube video before?
I don't know how.
Well, I mean, you're on one right now. It's not... You just do... Act normal. And maybe try to be funny.
Oh, yeah, you just act normal, dude. Just act natural. Bust a move in the middle of the fucking Wendy's. That's great. Just act normal.
What are you doing after this? You doing anything? You want to go party? Are you going to sleep or are you going to stay up?
Stay up.
Yeah? You want to go party? Where do you live at?
You want to go party, baby girl?
You live with your family, though, right?
Yeah.
I wish we could go party somewhere.
I want to go party.
You want to go party too?
Yeah.
I only live in... I live in my minivan, though. You want to go party in the minivan?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
What?
I don't know. I'm going to turn the video off. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you guys think? All right, well, let's see a poll of what the video. There's 200 people watching. Should we go? Okay.
So essentially, he just offered this seemingly developmentally disabled girl who probably doesn't know English very well to
go party in his minivan.
She's walking away. She's just out of there. Coincidentally, I'm sure.
I don't know what to do, guys. Yes. No, she's. Oh, she. What the fuck? I don't know what to do. I need advice. Was this gonna be on Reddit or some shit? I need to fucking know.
It's gonna be on Reddit. Oh, it's gonna be on your YouTube if you upload it for whatever reason you did. It's gonna be on Reddit. I think it's probably gonna be talked about for throughout the ages. One would hope.
Get the liquor first. Go. We don't need any liquor at this point. I'm drunk enough. Keep stream on. I don't know what to do. Buy condoms. I have condoms in the van. Wait, bro, at the table. That's his advice.
This is just this guy talking with his little fucking chat, like laughing away. Remember, from this girl's perspective, like, and from the perspective of the people around them, he's just like, oh, do you want to have a milkshake? I'll buy you a strawberry milkshake. Oh, let's dance. And you know, trying being quote unquote nice. And then she walks away and he's all like,
I got condoms in the van already. Yeah, I'm going to have sex.
He fucking doesn't care at all about like her in this situation or what her story is or what this guy that she's seated with is up to. This is truly the situation of a scummy guy who's getting cucked by an even scummier guy. At least it seems that way.
Fuck the shit out of her. Go talk to her about how much she paid. And we'll pull an ankle
with. Here's a good one.
Joshua, how are you?
Hi, Chris.
Take a seat. It's I need Chris to let Hansen. You know that my name is Chris Hansen. I'm doing a story on van predators that walk the streets.
Oink, oink!
And that was it? Oh, no.
Oh, no.
We had 200 viewers watching right now. She woke up homie. Where'd your buddy go? Did he leave? You got both the bags, huh? You go to the bathroom and pass out in the bathroom? Did your friend, did he black out in the bathroom or something?
No, she's over there with her guy, and you can see that the guy is, like, looking at him. She's, like, doing her thing on her phone, and he's probably like, hey, what's that guy asking you about? What's he up to? Why did you guys bust a move in the middle of the fucking diner? And she's just like, oh, he wants to take me to his van. Oh. And he's, like, looking over, and now he's concerned.
Where'd your homie go? Because both the bags are there, right? Nate Texas Beach $1. Yeah, right. Had to be 38 cents.
Make it easier for us to create memes.
Have you been to Vegas?
Huh?
You been to Vegas with us?
Yeah.
When'd you go there?
My mom and dad.
Aww.
We grew up.
That sounds fun.
Yep.
Oh, I think we're about to meet the next character of this saga.
Nothing. No?
I love your hair.
Huh?
I love your hair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go to red.
It's like my hair.
Yeah?
It's red.
Yeah?
Who's that? What's that hair? What's that noise?
No?
Good burp, dude. Very cool. Very nice burp.
Appropriate. These comments, guys, just so you know, it's not very nice. Be appropriate.
But yeah, you wouldn't want to be inappropriate in this stream. That would be bad.
What?
Oh my god, cryptic.
I like the way this guy's just like awkwardly kind of chuckling to himself this whole time, this like snorting.
Burgers, listen.
Now it's time for your helpful haunted hero of the week. Dr. Jane Leverett has been an infertility specialist for 27 years, but over the last 10, her clinic
he's going for it.
Okay, give us the text to speech. Come on.
They said that you look so young, though. Ooh, they said you look too young.
Oh, even the chat sees
they
it.
I don't think you're 25.
What well, she might be physically 25, but I'm pretty sure she ain't mentally 25.
Born. What year?
April 19.
18,
19? April.
What?
April.
April of what year?
19
what?
1992.
1992. 25. I'm 35. That's 92. I'm 82.
Wow.
Wow.
Where'd you go?
So I guess now we know his age. I was wrong. He actually is about the age that he looks, which is surprising. I thought he was, like, younger but looks older. One of those situations.
You were in the bathroom shitting that whole time? Did you, J.O.? I should have. Yo, he's back.
Yo, he's back.
Oh my god. These are my friends. These guys. What do you think? Oh, Dave, $3. Thank you.
Oh, $3. Thank you.
If you take Kurt to your van, at least drop her off at the human trafficking office and tell them you got a live one.
Again, these are on point. They're always good.
Whoa! Dave, don't talk about my future ex-wife like that. It's not nice.
My future ex-wife. Good God. Good God.
think you should. I can't block you because you give me so much money, but.
Who typed that shit?
That was Dave. Yeah, for $3, you guys can say whatever you want. Oh, someone's giving me $20.
Get the rib for her pleasure.
Get the rib for her
pleasure. What?
And again, it's like, it's funny to make jokes at his expense because he's the one that's orchestrated all this shit. So it's fine if you fucking make jokes about him. But when you start bringing the girl into it, I mean, yeah, you can make a joke about how she's probably being fucking human trafficked. That's not so bad. But when it turns into get the ribbed for her pleasure, like, goddamn, dude, don't say things like that. You can tell this girl's not all there. That's just,
get the ribbed for her pleasure.
Somehow everybody involved in this situation just seems to be completely oblivious or maybe just willfully doesn't give a shit about the fact that this girl's clearly kind of fucked up in the head, probably, in some manner or means. I'm trying to be as polite as possible, which is clearer when I say the term fucked up in the head, but it's like, it doesn't seem like it fucking bothers any of them at all. No matter how obvious it is.
You on Facebook?
Yeah.
Oh, what's going on over there? How many Facebook people you have on there? Mostly in the Philippines. Man, you miss home? Yeah, I miss home too. I'm from Indiana.
Wow.
Yeah, it's nice. Well, it's like all the cornfields and stuff, you know.
Apparently he doesn't miss Indiana enough to go back home to his fucking wife and kids, but,
You want any food? You said you didn't have any money for food. Can I buy you some food?
How?
Oh, use my money. I have money.
Wow.
Yeah. You want, what do you want? French fries or something?
Beer.
You want beer? Well, they don't have beer here. You have to wait until the beer opens. It opens in about... Oh, it opens in like 8 minutes.
You drink?
All the time?
Okay.
Like how even this guy is aware of the fact that it's a little weird to think of this girl who's, once again, clearly not all there, drinking. He's like, really? You fucking drink? They let you do that? Holy shit. Even he's not oblivious to it. And that's what makes it worse.
In the morning you drink?
No.
Well, you said right now you do. What is... You seem like such a nice girl. What are you into?
Huh? What are you into? Oh, that's a good fucking question for someone.
She's a nice girl.
I know.
You guys drink in the morning in the Philippines like that?
No. In the evening?
Well, if you drink in the morning here, it's the evening in the Philippines. It's party time.
Oh, God.
What do you like
for fuck's sakes.
What do you like about me?
What do you like about me? And that's a good face, really. That once again sums up the whole entire fucking stream.
I guess.
I mean, do you like anything about me or what?
I like you, my friend.
I like that I'm your friend. I'm your friend too.
All right, we can have sex now, right?
Because I have friends.
I have friends too. You're friends with me, I'm friends with you.
Is this Michael
Pope? I think it might be it might be that guy that's like, Michael, I think it's Michael something.
Oh, here's the friend. Here comes, speaking of Michael, here's like a homeless looking ass Michael from Lost.
Yeah.
White dude, huh?
What's that guy's name that did that song from, like, You Got a Friend for Me?
So now this guy's giving her cigarettes.
Got a friend, Randy Dixon.
Oh, no, that's Randy Newman.
Why does she give him the lighter?
Michael.
Why would she give him the lighter if he gave her the cigarettes? You see, once again, this is just a video that's filled with bizarre little mysteries like this that are just.
Michael McDonald. Michael McDonald. They said in the chat.
Someone in chat says drug deal, and well, stick around for more, friends. Oh, here we go again.
Burger, this is your flashlight again.
Oh, no.
I know I have been asking you for some time off, but in this case, I am happy to pump you if you take her home.
Well, that was my flashlight.
Even the flashlight's like, man, if it'll stop you from fucking taking this girl back to the van, it's fine. I'll do my duty. I'll close my eyes and think of England.
Tell me when you're done or something?
What? Nah,
he says something weird, right? He said make sure to call me when you're done or something. He said something weird, dude.
Wait, okay.
What did he say? Did he say that guy made money?
That
huh?
Huh?
Do you have to give him money?
No.
That man, okay.
Yeah.
Someone in chat says, if you do any drugs, you end up in a Burger Andy video before you die. Which, man, if only Captain Lou had warned people about that, the fucking opioid epidemic never would have been a thing.
Yeah.
How much?
I don't know.
Does he hurt you?
Mm-hmm.
He hurts you? The man out there hurts you?
Yeah!
Yeah! So here we have another fucked up part of this entire goddamn thing. Another just... what the fuck? Let's hear that again.
I don't know.
Does he hurt you?
Mm-hmm.
He hurts you? The man out there hurts you?
Yeah!
Fuck him!
Fuck him! That's my job, baby girl!
Man hurts you?
Yeah!
Fuck him! He hurts, like, hits you?
No!
Oh. Does he hurt you, though?
No.
Yeah, so again, now you can see the kind of contradictions that are happening. One second she's like, oh yeah, he hurts me. Yeah, he hits me. And then he keeps asking her, wait, so he hits you? And she's like, no, he's a nice guy. And it's like, what the fuck is true? Who can you really believe in this scenario? I honestly couldn't say.
The nice guy? Okay.
No, okay.
He said he's a nice guy.
Here comes the next member of the DK crew. So earlier in the stream, I believe that she mentioned that she lives with her cousin. Somewhere in town, I guess. And so this is, this would be the cousin, I believe.
Huh?
I don't know what to do. I don't think she understands the lesson. He's going to beat him up. A nice guy that hits her. She lying, save her soul. Be alpha, save her. A guy named Burger couldn't help. How does Burger end up in these situations? show her the love, man. Captain Sava. She's huh?
My cousin.
Hi.
My cousin.
Hello, cousin. Hello, new character to the stream. So this, once again, this person on the phone here, I guess she lives with this lady, and oh boy.
Hi. Good morning.
Hi.
We have another chocolate milkshake.
So imagine that you fucking are taking care of this girl, right? And she's like, you know, autistic or whatever the problem is with her. She's in some way disabled, and you get FaceTimed by her, and you see this fucking guy. You see Macho Man Andy Savage over here putting his arm around your cousin or whatever.
Cousin?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. She's my friend now.
Yeah.
She's my friend now. What the fuck are you gonna do about it, lady? Can you imagine how you'd feel about that? Like, you're just going about your fucking business, and then your person that you're taking care of is like, oh, hi, yeah, there's this guy now, and he's just like, yeah, we're gonna be real good friends. And my God, this is a horror. This is a fucking horror video.
I bought her a milkshake. How do you know you're from the Philippines too?
Yeah.
Her English is so good. Everybody knows English there, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Magaling ka daw mag-English.
I already met her family.
Oh, damn, is the wedding next week?
Kaibigan ko po. Look.
What? What's that about?
Here we go.
Okay. George, thanks for the $3.
Is that gingerly hair pimpin'? If so, you better eat that bunny's boy.
Oh my God.
To be honest, she looks like half the chicks and children I bunnies.
Oh my God.
What? I don't know. Some of the words were bunnies and kidneys and puppies. That means they said something bad. It's blocked.
This girl, once again, now she's on the phone with her fucking cousin or whatever. And the cousin is like, what is that noise? What the fuck am I hearing in the background?
Dave, thank you so much.
Oh, this one. This is a good one.
Wait. What does it say?
Blink your eyes if you are in trouble, young girl.
Blink your eyes if you're in trouble.
Oh my God. I feel so sorry for this fucking old woman on the phone who has to listen to this. And just like imagine being so worried about this girl while she's out doing this and you're just helpless and you're like, oh God, who is this man? What is this shit that's playing? What happened to my, like, person that I'm caring for? Cousin, whatever. What happened to her? You would be terrified if you were in this phone lady's position.
Speaking of her in Filipino?
Opo, restaurant.
Let's look up a thing in Filipino.
I really like the part, too, where he, like, specifically points the fucking speaker at the thing so that the woman on the phone can maybe try to translate the message to save her or something. Like,
Huh?
Oh, go get your milkshake.
Wait.
He left a cigarette, so he'll be back.
Man, I really wish I could go to the Tommy's Diner right now. Like, those burgers on the menu look good. There's clearly entertainment when you come here.
Doctor? Hi.
Hello.
Is it nighttime where you live?
Yeah, nighttime.
The sun is coming.
Also, it's even worse. This woman doesn't even live with this girl. She's just her cousin in Vietnam or fucking Philippines or whatever. So she just gets to be like, oh my God, what happened to my fucking cousin? Is she okay? This is terrifying. I feel so sorry for this woman.
Yeah.
Just became morning. Patricia, your cousin said you should go home. The sun is coming up.
Yes, you should go home because the sun is coming. That's definitely the reason. That's why you should go home, Patricia. Come on. Get away from this man.
I don't know. She said she just woke up. She's from a nap or something. I have no idea. She doesn't sleep in the restaurant. No, I don't know where she sleeps. I just met her. I don't know. She's a nice girl.
God, this is fucked up, man. This is fucked up. You're on the other phone and it's like, oh yeah, she's not sleeping in this diner. No, she's just, I just met her though, but I'll take real good care of her though. We're friends now. My God.
Don't talk with your mouth full.
Magbait gawa ko.
Now, keep in mind, we know the extent to which this guy is a scumbag, because this lady, she just gets to guess at the things that he might have said about her. But this guy, we've seen him get super chats about ribbed condoms for her pleasure and talking about bringing her into the fucking van and all this shit. Oh, don't worry, I got condoms already. And at one point, I don't know if we've seen it yet or if it's still to come. At one point, he says something to the effect of like, oh, I'm not going to need to get her liquored up. And yeah, so just once again, put yourself in the shoes of this relative of hers.
Ayoko nga dito. Hindi sa kanya din magpaligaw. Ayaw mo naman, di ba?
Don't believe me, just watch. Watch deeply into this man's eyes. Gaze therein and find your truth. It's so funny. It's just so funny. So I guess she's talking with her family here.
We can help you if you want.
Pingo.
Yep. What are the chances that he's checking out her ass? This is a great shot. What are the chances that this whole situation, the entire time her relative here is just asking him what the fuck this guy's story is and if she's okay?
Hindi pa ako, hindi pa ako uuwi, ate. Okay lang ako dito.
Oh, there goes the fucking friend once again. I didn't get to hear what he said there, but I'm sure it was biting. He seems to have acknowledged it. Can we hear that again?
Hindi pa ako uuwi, ate. Okay lang ako dito.
Okay.
Not sure what he said there, but I, for whatever reason, it appears that he trusts her with this girl or with this guy. Now again, for a long time in this stream, we did wonder if this guy was actually like some kind of, you know, social helper, you know, social worker kind of person who gets her around or whatever. And so even at this point, even though she said some things about him and that he hurts her or whatever, it's like, we were still wondering how true any of that was and if this was all just like some kind of misunderstanding. But of course, on the flip side of that, we were also wondering if this guy was like her trafficker, which, I mean,
hey, Patricia, this guy, who says it?
So I guess he's just going out. We'll be back.
Let's go leave, boy.
So apparently the girl said that she's not going home yet. She's okay. And the aunt or whatever is like, how are you okay when you're hanging out with random men? And, yeah, well, when one of those random men is Burger Andy, I mean, you can't argue that.
Let's go. Come on, let's go, Christian. This is our chance, Patricia. Let's go.
What?
We have to leave him.
Where?
He's leaving. Let's go.
Where?
Now you can be free.
Where?
I don't know. Let's go somewhere.
So he again seems to be somewhat aware of the possibility that this guy is mistreating her. And his solution to this is, no, I'll take care of you, sweetheart. You just got to get away from him. That's how you'll be safe, which, as you can imagine, seems to be more of a him issue than something about her.
Where'd you get that free trip?
Hi, Kuya Babe.
Hi. check.
Someone says, who wouldn't want a date with this tall bottle of mustard? Yeah, you are right. French's sandwich spread looking ass. Who is this guy that's talking now? I guess it's like the cousin's husband or maybe another relative of hers or something has given her a fucking lecture now about hanging out with people like Burger Andy. Once again, you just know that the lady on the other end of that phone is fucking flipping out and she's like, you know, yelling in Tagalog to her husband like, Jesus Christ, you gotta fucking, this girl is in danger, goddammit.
Is he bad man or good man?
Good man.
You sure we should leave? We can leave.
Oh god. Oh no. Oh no.
She looks like a survivor from Hiroshima.
Oh no.
She looks like half a village burned in butterfly fingerprint.
I just. It's not that the joke itself isn't funny. It's that she is right there. And that's just a bit fucked up. I mean, I don't know. Again, it's fine to make a joke like that if it's about him. If it's making fun of Burger Andy, because he's the one who orchestrates this whole fucking stream and makes this all happen. But when you start making jokes like this about survivors from Hiroshima, it's like, Jesus Christ, dude. This girl didn't ask to be here. This is just, scummy. Just really scummy.
Well, that's like your opinion, man.
That being said, the joke was, in a bubble, somewhat funny. I'm not gonna lie.
I'll talk about my future ex-wife like
that. A future ex-wife. Once again, you're the relative on the other end of the phone, and you hear this guy going, oh, my future ex-wife. Jesus Christ. And this whole time he's just staring intently at his chat. I really wish the chat was saved. I wonder how popular his stream was. I wonder if this fucking chat was popping off. You know, like, I gotta be real. Ice Poseidon might not have let him go on his bus or whatever, even after he ate that worm. And it might have been a classic moment in history, but I am more inclined to watch more of this guy's fucking streams than watch a single one of Ice Poseidon's goddamn streams, so there's that. This guy at least has that going for him. I can imagine this guy getting a cool 1,000 or so viewers, maybe even more.
That's how much.
Ask how much. I just love the whole time he's just reading these, like, sexual super chats and things, and just like, it's so funny. This wouldn't even be really all that acceptable if she was normal in the head, but in addition to being developmentally disabled, so it would seem, she also just doesn't speak very good English, so it's clear that she doesn't fully understand what's going on with him and this chat and the stream and everything. Once again, an underlying undercurrent of his streams and most IRL streams that I've seen seems to be just annoying people and exploiting people who don't want to be, like, on camera, who don't want to be filmed. And that's what this is, so.
Oh my god. I don't know what you're talking about, bro.
Now we got fucking red wine to underscore this. Once again, who the fuck put on Emotion FM from Vice City? Why is it the fucking Love radio station? Is someone having a laugh at the Tommies? Did someone legitimately see this interaction happening and they were just like, oh my god, this is gonna be hilarious. Let's put on the fucking Love Station. They're fucking dancing, doing ballroom dances in the middle of the goddamn fucking diner at 7 in the morning. It's like, it's...
Bruh.
It's gonna fall apart because it's a paper cup.
This woman's probably begging for her fucking family member to, like, return to the Philippines and come back home where she's safe. And really, we could only hope that that did happen. Once again, this was streamed 3 years ago. So, there's a very good chance that if not, Why does this guy look like Brendan Fraser after the divorce right now? Why is his mind breaking? Let's see if we can jump ahead a little bit here, see if anything really cool happens. Oh, we got another super chat coming up. Oh, there's the friend. Oh yeah, that's right, the fucking family member lady is still on FaceTime on the fucking table next to him. The girl just left the phone there with the FaceTime still happening, and the only company she has is this guy fucking minding his stream and reading his chat.
Don't type shit like that, shy.
Oh, here we go again.
Right now, please bring me to your van and maybe give me some white stuff on the down low.
Now that's one of my favorite super chats in this stream, but I will say that's one that was the relative on the phone got to hear, so that's fun. Again, they don't know what all this IRL streaming shit is. They've probably never fucking heard of Twitch, and they don't understand that this is humor. They're just terrified right now. Rightfully so.
Give me some white stuff on the down low.
I think he could.
Oh my god.
Wow.
So where are we now in this stream? I think we're getting close to the final. Oh yeah, she brought her lunch to the Tommy's Diner, that's right. I'm really not sure why they allow this all to happen at this fucking diner, because again, she came in here and she was like, I don't have any money. So why has she been here for fucking 6 hours? Maybe she wouldn't have been there if he didn't buy her the milkshake, but she apparently brought like a prepared sandwich or whatever to the Tommy's Diner. Dottie looks like a blobfish. Not a bully stream.
Smell good. Where'd you get a sandwich?
You smell good?
Ooh, that looks good. Was
really,
it?
Dude?
A cheeseburger?
Come on!
Bacon.
Yeah. Oh,
not
man.
Bacon.
Ooh, bacon? Bacon.
Chicken sandwich?
Bacon chicken?
Yeah.
Damn, that's nice.
Damn. It's almost like we're not sitting at a fucking restaurant right now.
Oh. So,
huh?
say Neo wrote this song.
Neo?
Yeah, dude, Neo is way better than Dark Souls. What's happening now? This stream is going to be fucking copyright claimed 7 ways for goddamn Sunday, I swear to God. Dealing with this one, if I upload it to YouTube, is gonna be a fucking... Ugh, this is gonna be a mess. I'm gonna have to edit this down in some way. Actually, if I remember correctly, the original plan was to cover this one on stream, but to probably do a bit of a you know, full commentary on camera video talking about the full Burger Andy picture. So that'll probably be what we do.
What?
And the what? Yeah, the two dudes are still sitting there with him. The thing you don't get to see throughout most of this stream is this guy's fucking friends trying to sleep in the diner in the booth across from him, and he's just, like, dancing with them and fucking all this crazy shit. This is truly, truly quite a situation. The hippest club in town, really. Oh no.
Thank you. Every time that noise goes, I make $3.
Do a threesome with the kitten guy. You know he wants it.
Oh man, dude, this guy is just on top of the world right now. Every 20 minutes when we hear that noise, he makes a whole $3. Wow, that really makes up for this entire fucking stream and all of the time you've spent. Wow.
Who's the kitten guy?
Maybe Dean or something?
Say hi.
Hi.
Go with the video.
You going to sleep?
Yeah.
Have a good night.
Have a good night. I'll take care of your girl for you. Sweet dreams.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
So... here we go again with this.
I slept from my bed. Like, I went out to sleep, I slept for like this. Like,
whoa!
Like, and now my neck.
Wow!
Has that ever happened to you? Where you sleep like sideways and it's like your neck hurts? Where did your boyfriend or your friend go?
I don't know. He's smoking.
Oh, he's smoking. So are we gonna transition? No, we still have a ways to go. All right, well, keeps remain seated, boys.
Why do we have to give him money?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
Do you give him money all the time?
No.
So you said you want to get some beers? What kind of beer do you like?
Bud Light.
Bud Light? Me too.
Discerning tastes right there.
It's my favorite beer.
I do?
I like any beer, I don't care. It is?
Once again, this is just happening this entire fucking stream. This entire time, these guys are just trying to fucking sleep in this diner. I feel sorry for this dude who's just had to fucking... be lulled to sleep by this guy trying to woo the special needs girl. That's great.
Oh, you can.
It's not my favorite, but it's one of my favorite beers. Oh, you're kind of making his head move. Hey, can I kiss you?
Huh?
Oh God, stop!
Where?
On the mouth?
No!
Oh, why not? I want you.
Look into his eyes, chat. Look into his soul.
Oh, no.
So I'm pretty sure that the next big subplot of this stream is about to happen. I'm very excited.
What? I got it.
It's okay.
No, I don't want to fall on the floor. Is it from Denny's? What is that?
I don't know.
You got it from a Juicy Burger?
I'm looking at a Juicy Burger right now.
Here, you want to get some Bud Light and go party?
Yeah!
Oh, God. Oh, this poor fucking girl doesn't know what she's goddamn saying. God damn it. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Where?
We could go to my party in my van or something.
Come on, we have
fun. Maybe we could just go walk around.
No. Like now?
Yeah. You're just gonna walk around the boulevard or something?
Now, you must be wondering at this point, how's he getting out of this fucking restaurant without dealing with the pimp first, or the boyfriend, or the friend, or the sex trafficker, or whatever the fuck this guy is? And once again, let me tell you, chat, you have no fucking idea where this is going with this guy. I'm not saying anything. All I'm saying is you will never see it coming. I gotta add that meme to my soundboard.
Oh no. How much are you at? 44%? Seems like all the junior.
Hello? Up and down.
Up and down. Fuck you guys. I'm only doing it for content.
I'm only doing it for content. You know, this is truly content, Burger Andy. I just don't know if it's the kind of content that you think it is. You think you're the one in control of the situation, but actually you're the spectacle. You've just made yourself the spectacle. And that is content, but not for you.
Trying to save her.
This bag of gas that is a person. The brief looks that we get at the people behind the counter really add to the experience, in my opinion. Because you know, they're watching. They get to watch this whole fucking thing unfold. And they're going home later and they're telling their friends. There's probably a dude who went home later and chilled with his friends on Discord and was like, "You will not believe what I saw today when I was at work." And this is frankly, they should be paying him. They should be paying him like an old tavern would pay a bard to strum some tunes on his lilt, his harp.
Okay. I don't know, Burger. Just leave me and let her be. Yeah, I know. I don't know. I want to help her. Let's go walk around.
Go walk around. He wants to help her, guys. He's a very nice guy. You know, when I look at this friend, what I think is nice guy who just wants to help.
She's 25, guys. They said that you look so young. They said you look young.
Yeah, I am.
Well, they said you look like you're 17.
Wow.
She's 25.
Who?
The viewers, they're just saying stupid stuff. She's calling the whole village, telling them she's getting married. Oh, God.
Now, I'm waiting again. Like I said, there's a critical subplot that unfolds here, and I'm hoping we didn't pass by it.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Is he okay? Do you know him, really, or you just meet him tonight?
Oh, I think this is it.
Did you meet that guy tonight, or do you know him?
Tonight.
You just met him tonight?
Yeah.
He might be a bad guy. He's trying to get money from hanging out with you. He's trying to act like a... He's what?
Huh?
He wants what? He wants marijuana.
Marijuana, everybody! Fucking... new fucking subplot! Okay, here we go. So... the moment that we heard that there was, like, marijuana, some kind of drug deal involved in this situation, it got pretty fucking real pretty fucking quick. We started to wonder. We started to wonder a lot of goddamn things. We started to wonder if maybe she's playing this whole fucking role and she's actually the drug kingpin and it's some Breaking Bad shit. We started to wonder if that guy was the drug kingpin. Maybe she's just a mole. Or rather, a mule, sorry. I know things. I know street lingo, don't worry about me. But we started to have a lot of theories about this whole drug situation. What the fuck's going on with the drugs? So, yeah, that's that.
Oh, I smoke marijuana.
Huh?
I smoke marijuana too, but... So you don't even know him? Well, he's not your friend. Fuck him.
Fuck him.
You don't owe him anything, hun.
Fuck the Oscars.
You can do whatever you want. You don't owe him anything. He's not your boss, is he? Do you need me to help you?
Huh?
You want us to tell him to leave you alone?
Tell him to leave you alone.
Huh?
Yeah, just show the sex trafficker or whoever he is. Show him the fucking live stream of all the people going, stop! Stop it! Stop it! I'm sure that'll make him come to his senses. Yes, he is in fact white knighting now.
He wants marijuana. A lot of people smoke marijuana, that's okay.
Hi, I'm Bixby.
Hey, Bixby.
Wow. How do you know that?
How do I know what?
She's, like, fascinated by Bixby on this guy's phone. Which, for those of you that don't know, I think is some kind of, like, Siri ripoff. I have it. I don't use it. Someone says that Burger Andy has the human Pepe face, which, I mean... yeah. Kinda.
Are you sure you'll be okay?
Yeah, what?
I just worry about you. I don't want you to be all alone. It's dangerous, maybe.
I know.
I worry about you, because you're a nice girl. I don't want you to hang out with the wrong people or something.
Oh, we've got another, like, fucking ballad playing. People say this is My Girl. I don't recognize it, but I guess it's a popular song. Yeah, I'm consistently amazed by the... perfect soundtrack for this fucking stream. It's perfect. Scared? It's just perfect.
Of that guy?
So Kino.
No.
I don't trust them. Oh, wait, he's outside. Oh, shit. He's still here. He's, like, right there.
You'd almost feel like this is fucking faked. Like, you've got a song playing that would be playing right... if this was a scene in an indie movie... where this guy got fucking rejected by this girl who's like got a pimp or whatever this guy is, and this whole scene is happening and he's like crying into his fucking burger at Tommy's. This song would be playing. This is the perfectly chosen My Girl. This is the fucking perfectly chosen song for this situation. I love this. You'd have to think that this was fucking fake, but somehow it's real. Somehow this just happens to be the music that's playing in the background during this situation.
Oh no, he's still here. I thought he left. He's like right there. Oh, I'm worried, hon. I'm just worried about you.
Why?
I'm worried about you. You might go home with him tonight instead of me. So, we're about to meet the friend. You guys ready for this situation? You guys fucking ready to meet the friend?
I didn't buy any blow. He's talking about herb. I didn't buy him anywhere. So he has some Death Star OG.
Death Star OG is not a very good... It's fine.
Wanna hear some cool music? Check out Devin Real Cuddy. You understand me? SoundCloud, Devin Real Cuddy. /Beezy's. That's B-E-Z-Z-E-Y. Beezy's.
Word. Is that your homie?
So this guy just comes along all of a sudden, and it turns out he's a SoundCloud rapper. All of a sudden, he just enters from stage fucking right, and he's just like, "Hey, y'all, check out my fucking SoundCloud, dude, Devin Real Cuddy." And so that's where this goes.
Young Devin Real Cuddy, you understand me? Related through bands. / Dog Habit Gang, Dog Pound Affiliate.
Where you from, man?
This might as well be Viper right now. This may as well just be... He may as well have just run into fucking Viper in this situation. I want you to know how far we've come, chat. I want you to consider all of the theories that were abound about who this guy was. And he just fucking pops into frame. Just like...
Cool music, check out Devin Real Cuddy. You understand me? SoundCloud, Devin Real Cuddy. /Beezy's. That's B-E-Z-Z.
So he just starts chilling his fucking SoundCloud, I guess.
/ Dog Habit Gang, Dog Pound Affiliate.
Where you from, man?
I gotta know who your boy fucking with.
Oh boy. This is like a thinly veiled threat to fucking Burger Andy here. This is a ballsy move, honestly.
That's real. Check out your music.
Go smoke some gas.
Shit, man, my gas puff. Fuck.
Death Star OG.
Now, I'm not going to be showing what we found, but we did look up this guy and the name Devin Real Cuddy. And his SoundCloud and whatnot. I don't remember if we found his SoundCloud. But we did find his Facebook, and there was no pictures of Patricia on there, so that was sad. Not friends with Patricia either. Maybe he was, and that's just not her real name. I don't know. But we couldn't find Patricia. But we did find this guy. And again, I'm not going to be showing that on this stream. I don't think that's necessary. But it's a pretty fun Facebook. And Devin Real Cuddy. He gave us all his fucking info, so I mean, we should probably check out his fire mixtape. I don't know.
Let's go smoke.
So now it's time to go smoke a fucking blunt with this whatever this man is, the SoundCloud sex trafficking pimp boyfriend or whatever the fuck he is.
Yeah, I'd get your stuff too. Yeah,
she don't want him.
Someone in chat says, let's use his info to arrest him. I really don't think there's anything to be arrested about. Don't do anything fucking stupid, chat. You're not the goddamn police. You're not fucking Batman. Just watch the stream and shut up. This is a 3-year-old stream. So, yeah, don't do anything stupid. Although, there's Donald Trump in the background, so that's kind of cool.
This is your stuff, too. I know these guys, they wouldn't steal it.
So we're leaving here, and we're gonna go out here and chill with Devin Real Cuddy and the girl.
You smoke weed too?
Fuck yeah.
You're cool as fuck. You like that milkshake?
Strawberry. Man, he's really fucking fixated on this like $3 milkshake that he bought her. God damn.
Love it. They got pretty good food here, you know, it's good like late night, you know, it's cheaper than Denny's.
You get a little more for your money.
34, I've been coming to Tommy's pretty much my whole life.
You're 34?
I've been going to the original Tommy's.
34 and 35.
Yeah, about the same age.
Yeah.
And 25.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's still trucking along.
She's still trucking.
Huh? He said, you're still looking good? Hell yeah.
Well, you're still looking good. I guess he means she still looks underage, so there's that.
Live my life in the streets. I'm gonna use that. I've been all through these streets, fake as fake, right? Getting love from these freaks, because they feel me, right? Baby mama hiding kids from their father, right?
So then he just starts fucking rapping at us, guys. I wanted to say earlier that this stream, you will not fucking expect it, but it literally turns into a fucking musical. But I felt that that would be spoiling it. So just watch.
Telling me to go to court, man, that ain't right. I love all of my kids. I hope they missing me. I hope they playing my music. When they missing me, y'all the love of my life. This is killing me.
Chat's talking about fucking trying to get this guy arrested. Listen to this soulful voice. Come on. This is just a dude who loves to hang out at the Tommies and you know, rap and occasionally maybe pick up some autistic chicks or whatever it is he's up to. But, you know, how can you hate this man with his golden voice? Come on.
And dotted line, full custody. Heard you been telling my kids things is not true. It's not cool, because my love for my kids true. I can't face life the way I need to without my kids. I can't figure out what to do. And all this pain that's built up inside of me, it made me hate you for things that you did to me. I can't believe.
I like how in this quick, in just this, like, the last minute, we have fucking turned the narrative completely. I mean, we didn't like Burger Andy before, but we had such concerns about this guy and what this guy might be doing. Oh, he's probably a sex trafficker. He's probably like that type of guy. And he's gonna report back to his people later or whatever, and they're gonna... But no, he's just some fucking SoundCloud rapper. He's just some jolly fucking rapper who likes to smoke pot. And meanwhile, Burger Andy is the one who's been making all these kinds of fucking weird comments and buying her milkshakes and making her fucking, like, give him massages and shit. It's like, my God. It really puts it into perspective. This guy is the least scummy dude in this situation right now.
Away from you, when we done been through hell and back. What the hell is wrong with you? I cried day and night. They asked me what's wrong with me. Everything is wrong.
And by the way, if you listen to the lyrics of this guy's rapping right now, he's basically rapping about how he misses his kids and he loves his kids, which that's a whole other fucking story. Maybe he might not, for whatever reason, he got his kids taken away from him, it seems. So maybe he might not have been the greatest of fathers. Nobody's saying anybody's perfect here. But hey, at least this guy misses his fucking kids. Can't say the same for Burger Andy, huh?
Kids with me. I just pray to God and hope they miss me.
But Burger Andy fucking comes out here gloating about the fact that he's never going back to his wife and kids. Like, goddamn.
And tell the judge you miss me and all the things they really miss about me. He'll understand that you really need to be with me until the day you see me. Look, just smile in the mirror and know that daddy loves you. Gang, I've been on through the streets, state to state, right?
Hey, but
getting love from these freaks, ooh, yeah, they feel me right. Baby mama hiding kids from their father, right? Telling me to go to court, man, that ain't right. Devin Real Cuddy, SoundCloud.
He's just out here trying to shill his fucking SoundCloud. I guess at some point he picked up on the fact that this guy's on YouTube or whatever, and he's like, oh, I can use this dude to fucking promote my SoundCloud or whatever. Honestly, he's not even that bad of a rapper. The song's got kind of a catchy sound to it. I don't hate it.
Hey. How long you been smoking cigarettes?
Huh?
You gotta stay off the cigarettes. Only smoke weed is better for you. Yeah. The cigarettes will make you sick.
Huh?
The cigarettes is not good for you.
I know.
Well, I guess the weed ain't too, but I love
it. Oh, don't worry. There's so many things in the situation that aren't good for her.
Partake, don't hate.
So, the next, like, fucking 10 minutes of this stream, are just this guy like taking over Burger Andy's entire chat. He's got such a charisma about him.
What? Is he gonna charge you for the weed?
Everything costs. This is America, goddammit.
I like this guy. Oh, he's live? Oh god. Well that's fine. Let him be live.
He said $40 massage.
Donald Trump would charge your ass just for speaking at his rally.
Yeah.
$10,000. Shit. I should get at least $15,000 for this motherfucker right here.
He's not wrong. Burger Andy should be paying him for his performance right now, but I mean I don't think charging people to speak at a rally is necessarily. You mean like on the stand, like on the podium? Of course you're gonna charge them.
Oh, it's
good value. Y'all check out Related Through Band. You know what I'm saying? My nephew turned up the low. You understand me? Real young, proper cat. You know what I mean?
Yeah, again, someone in chat says he's chill, except for that he's also trying to like hit on this poor girl, and you're not wrong about that. That certainly is a black cloud hanging over this whole interaction. I want to like this guy and his fun fucking SoundCloud rapping and like his everything costs. It's America, motherfucker. And it's like he seems like a fun guy, except that he's also kind of hitting on this girl who seems like she's not all there. So that's not great.
And get some money. You know what I'm talking about? She want to get blessed. Fund me, feed the children, you understand me? And we out here, I'm saying 10 toes down. Fuck it, get you 30 toes down, and then you come really see a real one. You know what I'm talking about? Devin,
I don't know why we're hearing a fucking car wash sound now, but I'm pretty sure that's him admitting to like, oh yeah, she wanted some money, so now she's with me, I guess. But for the rest of this segment,
hey. Let it go and run.
This dude's just fucking rapping for like 10 minutes.
Damn. That's hot. They're camping over here. Let me see if I can get some music. Where's the speaker at? Where's the speaker at? She teases me, so I'm all up on her merry go. I can't take it, so just let me off this merry-go. Don't play no games, I'm getting off this merry-go. We running games, so that means I'm on her merry-go-round. Merry-go-round.
Apparently this is his song, which again, not bad. It's not a bad song.
Her merry-go-round, I'm on her merry-go-round. She's tripping till I pull quick. I got game from the pulpit. Real one getting paid quick. Never roll, don't play quick. Makes sense that she's full of shit. I don't know how to handle it. Ray jump, get away from it. Keep tripping, I gotta go.
No, we're not fucking raiding the goddamn stream. How many times do I need to tell you people? There's some of you here who aren't even fucking new, and you're like, oh, let's go raid! Let's do a raid! Fuck off. Ban yourselves. Fuck.
Y'all crazy.
All right, well, you know, that's about it anyway for the Patricia saga. He leaves, he doesn't get with the girl, but he walks off, and he, like, talks with his friend here about how, man, life's crazy. You know, you bought a girl a milkshake and she didn't go party with me in my van and drink Bud Light and all this shit. He just kind of recounts the events of the day. There's a little bit more to the stream where he talks to some of the recurring characters of his fucking neighborhood or whatever. But more or less, that's about it for the Patricia saga. So, yeah, I think that will do it for the stream now. We've been going for a little while. And I think maybe sometime we might look at another stream of his, maybe a couple more streams of his. But for now, I think I'm going to call it here.